Hello everyone and welcome back to our Let's Play series. Today we are looking at Steel. This is the second Steel video I've done. And this one differs in that I've tweaked the full tank build a little bit. And I think I've optimized the cards just right. So, what have I done? First off, I am not going to go for health, mana, or guard. I'm going to go straight for the tempered plate. I've added, I've tweaked around the upgrade so that I didn't get to bubble tap last time, and bright steel also was going to be second last. So I just kind of shifted it all around so that in the early games we get the better upgrades. And that it makes us more powerful quicker. So last time I went with charge to go forward. The thinking was that I'd be able to engage and be more disruptive faster and better with my Q. I'm going to do the same thing. Use the charge. And hopefully I can get behind people easier, I can disrupt people, and ensure that kill better. So, okay. So I was a little bit late, all the talking and stuff. Hopefully this, I can hit that, okay, well. I mean, that was an interesting occurrence. If you guys haven't noticed already, I'm playing versus AI. As the second time I've played Steel, the second video I've made, we're still trying him out, getting used to how he plays, and exactly, you know, what do I have to do to be the best tank, to be the best Steel? Hopefully, I am much better this game. I've been a little bit late to these engagements, so let's work on that. What else have I noticed about Steel so far? I really enjoy his mobility with his Q and his R. I have already hard engaged and hard disengaged with both my Q and the R, and it adds a really unique aspect to Steel, because you can, with relative, with relative certainty, you can engage fairly hard and still disengage fairly safely. I know that there is a relatively prominent build with Steel as a fighter, for that exact reason. He can engage really hard and then disengage as equally as hard and reliably. So that means that people can go in, do that damage, and then get out. There's one video that I would love to say who it was from, but I just don't remember. My apologies. Of a Steel going full on brawler. I think it was Paragon Pro Gaming, who went very nice 5-minute guide of his build. Obviously, Master Skin, where okay. So let's engage hard on this Mirio. Hopefully this gadget follows. Trying to get behind her, but there we go. Yeah. So you can see I'm doing a fairly nice job of getting in her way. That energy barrier worked out really well. I don't know what this manual is doing. She should have kept coming back. that's just how the computers are at the moment. Hopefully they get much, much better. Yes, as I was saying, this brawler Steel was just wrecking his face, like jumping in, doing that crazy amount of damage with his shield slam, with his ultimate, and just being a force on the battlefield. It was actually really, really quite interesting. I think maybe the next video I'll try a brawler Steel. So I'm actually very interested to see how he is. Given how I've been playing him, I'm gonna get out of here just because I want that experience. It's gonna be taken out as well. Yeah, let's go in on this Mariel. Let's see. And can I get out of here? Oh, just barely. I'm really, really lucky there. Either the Mariel missed or she focused the... Oof, can I help her? Yeah, okay, no, she's good. Yeah, so if I'm gonna try a fighter Steel, I need to focus on my engages, my disengages, and really pay much more attention on my health. And am I staying my welcome? That's gonna be a very important part of playing Steel for sure. So already I'm liking the health upgrade quite a bit. I mentioned last video that I'm gonna engage Sparrow here. See if the scraps follows. Oh, my Grex almost barely missed with his pull. Yeah, I'm liking the health. I think if I do another tank video with Steel, I'm gonna maybe add in some more health. I didn't put that many upgrades in this deck. Okay, so here's a perfect example of why, like, I should be using my shield, my barrier, but I'm just not. So here I'm sticking in front of my ranged characters, just absorbing this damage, letting my ranged characters do damage, trying to be that force here. Oh, Sevra came in. Okay, so I'm gonna try to stay as much as I can, but I'm pretty low. I don't think I can do very much. Ooh, nice. Okay, so I need to use that force shield much better. I didn't use my right click that whole time. I should have. I mean, I was taking all that damage. Boy. Don't do this. Use your right click, use your E if you're just sitting there taking that damage. Use it. Use those skills. That's what they're there for. In this case, this one is the better tuned barrier into this. We're gonna go with greater barrier, greater health, greater barrier. That one. Okay. Alright, let's focus. Let's focus. Let's use these E and right click abilities much, much better. So we've pushed left and mid lanes. We have right lanes, so maybe I'll say Well, you know what? No, we don't want to end this too early, so we're just going to leave. We're just going to leave it. You know, let's hard engage, maybe, with Gadget. Okay, she has to leave. We have Thin Map coming in. Let's see. Let's put the shield down. Okay, let's engage. Let's get on this Muriel. Sparrow is over there. Get this Muriel. Good. Alright, we're gonna get behind. Okay, so that Sparrow's still back there. I don't think we have the screen. No. I'm gonna head back. I'm gonna head back. Up to the Sparrow. Where is she? Okay. Well, I guess that we're not gonna do that much. But, what was that? Alright, I'm going crazy. Apparently can't keep track of the enemy. Okay, so we have two characters here. Let's go in on this Grim. Whoa, what was that glitch? You guys saw that, right? Yes. I don't know what that was. Maybe the Grim used his displacement ball thing. When I was charging, and that kind of interrupted my charge. So the right lane's being pushed. I have no mana. I'm about to ding on card power, so let's ding on card power and then get out of here. So again, okay. So another tip: don't go to absorb enemy's damage and still be in trouble mode. So without mana, steel feels pretty useless actually. So maybe that mana potion would be a good thing to have. Okay, so far I think the force shield has been the most useful for my team. I'm gonna head back, get some mana, get a mana potion, and then come back and help out. That's this mid lane here. Enemy so I said I was going to go for the barrier and leave just enough for that mana potion. Perfect. I'm going to undo. I have my health on one, mana on two, and three is usually a token of some kind, and then my four is the ward. Just because that's. Oh, I've gotten used to it. So this greater barrier and guard should help out, or sorry, greater barrier and this health should help out with their energy damage. They have 1, 2, 3, 4 energy damage, so I should be actually trying to stack that more so than anything else. So in that last little bout of fighting, pretty much all of it was energy damage, so there's a Gideon over there. Hello. And let's get out of here. Okay, so you guys saw that as well, I hope, right? This Fing Mao needs to get out of here. I'm not sure what's happening with this Q. I'm having a fair amount of lag. I'm sorry about that. My computer is not the most... not the biggest powerhouse. I don't know what that Fing Mao is doing. I am staying my welcome. I don't think I have enough damage to take out this Gideon, so I'm going to have to leave. I'll call for help. This Gadget is coming. So when this Gadget gets here, I'm going to hard engage on this Gideon. Oh, apparently I missed. Okay, I mark up this Gideon. Oh, my apologies for this lag. I'm not sure exactly what's going on. One Gadget. Definitely skidding. Okay, I'll slow him down. Okay, I didn't... So, there seems to be a delay between... you for when you actually throw your barrier, your force shield, and when it actually deploys. So keep that in mind when you are all not getting up. And this should be the end of it. I think Gadget's not doing very much damage, but I don't know what she's expecting for. Okay, hopefully we can take out this Severog. I'll try to get in between him and Gadget here. I haven't been using my mana potions. I've forgotten all about it. Okay, so let's see if I can stay here long enough to kill this Severog. I'll knock him up. See what I can do here. Severo's not doing very much damage, and thank you! Good job. Thank you very much, Murdoch. Okay, so that was pretty good. So against a tank, you can see that our damage reduction is doing a really good job. That Severo was hitting me for 30, I think, so it's doing a really good job. I would guess that let's go for the health. Let me get that barrier and go into that that order card later. As for orbs, as you can see, mana has been a little bit of an issue, so the blue orb could certainly be a possibility. Although likely you will have somebody else that could use that orb much better than yourself. So a Muriel, especially Decker, a Sparrow, would use that blue orb much, 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 much more than you. Of course, a Gideon. So, I mean, if they're not around, if they're dead, and you get the blue camp, I guess you could certainly fail its hard engagement here. Okay, totally missed. This will miss as well. Definitely not a very good job of getting in there. I could have been in trouble mode a little bit farther and have actually reached there, probably gotten my grim as well. So we secured that kill, we got that experience. We're going to go into this left lane and help take out this inhibitor. So actually, take a look at my mana bar. I was halfway there, halfway with my ultimate Q, and that was it. So, I think Steel could certainly take advantage of a mana upgrade, perhaps. But I think that's just I think the mana issue comes more from just not using my skills effectively. The two games ago in my Murdoch PvP video, the enemy Steel was doing a really good job of staying in travel mode, just to the point where he was either going to be attacked or where he needed his ultimate or Q to engage. I definitely need to be doing that much, much more. Using my travel form. Yes, I'm a druid from World of Warcraft. Using my travel mode to get to the enemy much, much better. And then, you know, hitting my Q, hitting my R at the very last moment before I'm gonna be hit or whatever, and then engage from there. Because using the Q and then using the R to engage, I mean, while that could be effective on a very big ambush kind of situation, ideally you want to get there with your Q and R readily available. So here I'm going to have to get in a little bit. I'm going to use this to help protect. Okay. So that E does stop projectiles. I'm gonna use this, hopefully to stop this Gideon. Let's see what we can do here. I'm gonna have to use my right click to get out of here. This is a Severog, wants to play. Let's see what we can do here. Let's use this to stop his advance. Good. Stop his retreat. Oh my goodness, I'm sorry for the leg. It's really quite ridiculous. Okay, I'm gonna hopefully secure this kill. I have not enough mana to get out of here though. I'm dead. So I thought there that I had enough mana to use my ultimate to get out. But I didn't. So it looks like this game is over and we are barely really getting going. I mean, that's the good thing about versus AI games is that they're not very long, and they're really good for getting used to a character, but they don't last very long, so you don't really get the full appreciation of a character. So we're going to go into the... I said that we were going to go into this, but the Tomb Barrier. I'm really liking the... adding the barriers with the periodic health in there. I think this balanced approach is going to be the best for steel. I'm thinking that's going to work the best. Once we have more upgrades at our disposal, we'll be able to, for each card, you know, equipped a variety of upgrade cards so that you can tailor how you use those upgrades, how you use those cards to better suit the enemy team. So for example, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 energy damage dealing characters on the enemy team. I'm not sure if Sevrog does he do... Yeah, I think he does physical damage. So I'm not sure. Once we have more cards, we'll be able to tailor our... And tons of leg. I'm very sorry about the leg. I'm not really sure what's going on. So in this second video, I've done a little bit of a better job, engaging properly. I'm standing in between my team and the enemy team, absorbing that damage, using my E to block those shots, and just kind of facilitating the rest of my team and doing their job. Really, that's your job. You're the ultimate facilitator. So to go over, we started with tempered plate, got 1 health and 2 guards. We went into a tomb barrier and a mana potion with 2 barriers to 1 health. 2 barriers to 1 health. This tune barrier also follows that. It has 2 barriers and 1 health, and then we would have gone in with that order card. So his I like Steel. He's tricky, which I actually appreciate. It's an opportunity to learn to develop some skills that I'm sure will apply to other characters. So if you're having issues with engaging at the right time, with disengaging at the right time, and how you're doing that, are you using your skills to disengage and then you're kind of useless at that point? If you're having those issues, Steel's actually, so far, a good character to work on that. I mean, I actually really enjoy doing that with Steel. Build-wise, I'm really liking the 2 barrier or armor to 1 health. He definitely seems to like health, obviously. Any character I'm assuming would. So we're gonna try another video of him being a tank. We're gonna try it in PvP, so hopefully the matches are much longer. Flesh out our cards, see how he plays then. I'm really interested to see if he can be that rock solid tank that just really can't die. And obviously having the skills to play him that way, we'll have to see how that goes. So thank you very much guys for watching the video. I hope this was at least helpful or shed some light on a few things. If anything, this was an example of what not to do, but that's gonna be worked on. Guys, like, dislike, subscribe, share this content. There's lots more to come, so I hope that it was helpful in at least some way. Really hope that you enjoyed it, guys. Till next time, take care. Bye-bye.